eine, die immer lacht. Die immer lacht, die immer lacht, die immer lacht.
Zweites Viertelfinale und wir freuen uns auf den zweimaligen BDO-WM-Finalisten, den World Masters Champion von 2004. Mervyn King tritt an gegen die aktuelle Nummer 10 der Welt, spielt eine klasse Premier League Saison, hat schon 3 European Tour Turniere gewinnen können, hat in diesem Jahr bereits 2 Pro Tour Turniere auf dem PDC Circuit für sich entscheiden können. Aus St. Helens der Bully Boy Michael Smith. Viertelfinale Nummer 2 wird gecalled von The Voice, Russ Bray.
The German Darts Open has been blown wide open tonight with a defeat for Michael van Gerwen at the hands of Stokes number 1, Ian White. There remain just 2 men in the field who have won Euro Tour titles before, and they face each other in the quarterfinals as the bully boy Michael Smith takes on the king, Mervyn King. Merv won his title back in Sindelfingen in the Glass Palace 2014. It was the last time that he claimed a ranking title in the PDC. Is he going to end his 4-year wait for another one? Or can Michael Smith go on and claim a 5th Euro Tour title and his 3rd title of 2018 already? Ian White awaits the winner. Ian White been practicing with Michael Smith. Evidently, it's been paying off. The other half of the draw, Hopp versus Cullen, Price versus the world champion Cross. None of those guys have won a Euro Tour title before. And with no Peter Wright and no Michael van Gerwen, it might be one of the best chances they are going to get. But look at the quality of the players still left in.
First leg, Mervyn, the throw first. Game on!
The bully boy versus the king. The cat is well and truly amongst the pigeons here in Saarbrücken, and Mike Lawrence is well and truly in the commentary box.
Yes, the Saarlander Harler still reeling from that whiteout suffered by MVG just moments ago. 83. So yes, we'll certainly get 2 new finalists that compared to the first 2 events of 2018, which have been contested between Michael van Gerwen and Peter Wright. And only 2 men, those 2 men, have won more European titles than Michael Smith's 4. Phil Taylor's also won 4. MVG dominant at 22 titles and Peter Wright at 6. And just that one title you mentioned on the European stage for Michael van Gerwen. Michael Smith. That one title for Mervyn King, I should say, as Michael Smith hits his first 180 of the match.
6-4 win against Steve Lennon, a 6-3 win this afternoon against Jelle Klaassen, and Michael Smith upping his average from around about the 95-96 mark against Lennon 96. To the 100 against Jelle Klaassen. It's been around about that 95 level for Mervyn King all weekend so far, but he has taken out 2 huge dangers in James Wade, who made the semis of the first 2 Euro Tour events of the year, playing great stuff, and Darrell Gurney, the Grand Prix champion. Gets the treble, but cannot pin the double. Would have been a breaker throw and a 12 darter.
Mervyn, you require 80.
Oh, the Merv route's gone wrong. It's gone horribly wrong.
40. Michael, you require 80.
So for a breaker throw right at the start of the game, Getting closer for that double nine, but just inside. That's always the danger on the double nine. Tops then for Merv.
Missing doubles like Michael van Gerwen. Merv. It's a gift for the bully boy. And back there.
Seven score. Mervyn, you require 10.
Bit careless. We both end up in the madhouse here.
Yes. Game well, gets the job done treating us, if that's the right word, to some mad out shots. First.
Game on.
And Russ Bray just the raise of the eyebrows to Mervyn King there as he walked back from the board.
What?
Mervyn King had to produce a stirring comeback earlier on this afternoon in his game against Daryl Gurney. It looked at 4-2 down, but Gurney was going to run away with it. Michael Smith firing in his second maximum, but Merv found a way to turn it around. And he stays very much in the hunt in this leg as well with his first 180. Oh, yes, yes, proper darts, proper darts.
They're cooking on gas now, these guys. This is great to watch.
Love to see that. Fire at a 180, the other guy comes back over the top with a 180 of his own and then just gets hit with another one. Wonderful stuff. Then they miss doubles. And we'll both end up in the madhouse.
Yeah, the cream rising to the top as we get to the business end of this European
16.
Tour event, the third of the year. Double 10 then. Game for a level game and no messing that time on the doubles.
Third leg, Mervyn for first, game on.
Very reliable on double 10, Michael Smith, in general.
More European Tour action streamed live for you next weekend here. The Austrian Darts Open, a new venue again this year. Premstätten. That's of course following on from the Premier League doubleheader for those players involved in Rotterdam, Wednesday and Thursday.
Yeah, Michael Smith will be there. Michael Smith really pushing for a playoff spot and looking very, very good for it as well at the moment. Produced one of, if not his best, televised display in the Premier League a couple of weeks back in whitewashing the five-time world champion Raymond van Barneveld with a 103 average. Wonderful stuff from the bully boy, and done with just a swagger that we're beginning to see a little more regularly from Michael Smith.
What?
Treble 20, treble 17, double top.
131. Mervyn, you require 76.
To nudge back in front. Double top with Smith poised on double 10, but it matters not. As Mervyn King takes it out.
One.
Michael Smith won on the Euro Tour last year, breaking the duopoly that Peter Wright and Michael van Gerwen held on the European Tour circuit. Did that in Gibraltar when he beat Mensur Suljovic in a final. He did make another final. That was in Austria, the Austrian Darts Open in Vienna, as you mentioned. It's a new venue we're going to this year in Austria. Been all over the place in Austria. Graz this time, Salzburg, Vienna, Innsbruck 1 year. Michael van Gerwen will not be there next weekend.
No, he's already confirmed he won't be entering that one.
Well, unless this defeat has changed his mind.
One!
Second maximum for Mervyn.
140. Mervyn, you require 136.
And encouragingly for Mervyn, in this second game of the day that he's played, we're not seeing him struggling with his back problems, or not seeming to.
Game show.
That's not particularly encouraging for Merv, Michael though, with Michael Smith hitting tops with the one dart he had at it. 2-2 level game.
Yes, and the players are used to playing multiple games in a day, especially on the floor tournaments, but it is a bit of a test, the Sunday of these European Tour events, if you do go all the way. Four games in a day. Especially as we know, Mervyn historically has suffered from back problems in the past.
I did speak to Merv at the start of the day and asked how he was feeling. He said, I feel fine. Sciatic nerve hasn't let me know if it's going to cause any problems as yet. And we've not seen any issues. But they are long sessions, these. You've got to win this one. And it's a extended format for the semis and the final, remember. Only by an extra leg for the semis and first eight for the final. If you get involved in some battles, 60. Even pretty rapid-fire ones like this, you can end up on stage for quite a long time.
One.
And as you can see, it is warm out there. Sell-out crowd all weekend for the Saturday and Sunday.
One.
And you mentioned the different locations in Austria. It is great that European Tour travels to different venues around Europe, giving darts fans a chance to come out and have a good night out and see some of the top stars of the sport throwing some top arrows.
90.
Not quite the top arrows that Mervyn King was hoping for there. Misses double 16, 82 for the bully boy. We'll start in the bullseye. It's two at double 16. You almost think he'd prefer one at tops.
Because
he's not a big fan of that area of the board. He will leave it, but not very often.
And Mervyn pounce. He can indeed.
Fifth leg. Mervyn King. Sixth leg. Michael to throw first. Game on.
And again, could be an important moment were Michael Smith to have taken out that 82 and broken, but it's not phased in. Ton 40 to kick off the sixth leg here. And the crowd starting to find their voices again after the murmurs, after the exit Michael van Gerwen at the hands of Ian White earlier. And they'll find their voices again next with the quarterfinal between
77.
The young German Max Hopp and Joe Cullen before Gerwen Price takes on Rob Cross. That should be a tasty encounter as well, the final quarterfinal of the session before we head to the semis and the final.
85.
This is, of course, a repeat of a Euro Tour final, the one that Mervyn King won in Sindelfingen. Michael Smith pushed him all the way there, actually missed championship darts for what would have been his first Euro Tour title, but he made up for it immediately. by winning the next one in Leipzig in East Germany.
And
he managed to go on and win a couple more within a 12-month spell, so not the same year, but within a 12-month spell, winning three Euro Tours. And stunning effort from Michael Smith that launched him up the rankings and eventually got him in the Premier League for the first time. Under pressure here, though. Another one of those. Oh, can't follow it. Oh, okay.
114.
Well,
keeping Ross Bray on his toes.
I mean, he has left top, so I'm not sure it's the wisest way to go. You can chuck that out the board and end up costing you. Mervyn, he's cost himself there.
31. Mark will require 40.
Really?
And double top hit.
Michael Smith.
Вирусная угроза была обнаружена.
Michael Smith, mid-90s, which is, you know, just shy of the 98 up towards 100 that he's been throwing for the weekend. But then again, Mervyn did manage to go through the gears and come from behind to beat Daryl Gurney. Is that in? It is in. 180 number four for the Bully Boy.
99.
Moving down to a big finish. Here they come piling in from Michael.
One
back to back 180 yet again.
167.
Oh, this hurts. This really hurts.
Oh,
360 points in six darts from Michael Smith to set up a chance of a break, and it's very nearly stolen away from him by Mervyn King with the second biggest outshot in the game.
Would have been a roof raiser. Double 10 now for Michael.
Game
hits it for 4-3.
Michael Smith. 8 leg, Michael throw first. Game on.
And you can see Michael Smith over the last few legs getting frustrated because he feels like he's the better player in this one. He is 10 points clear in the averages almost.
19.
There you see, 9 points. The first nine average particularly. And he's felt like he's the better player, but he's not been able to go into the lead until just then.
One runner.
But where is Michael Smith in the past? He used to beat himself up and get frustrated, and he wouldn't bring the best out of him. Here, he's managed to focus,
94.
And he's gone back-to-back 180s for the second time in the game, and it's given him that opportunity for the breaker throw, which he has then taken on double 10. And it's the best leg of the match, in fact.
40.
Yes, impressive stuff as...
Oh, Merv. Merv. Steady. Have to get some heavy lifting equipment if that happens again.
One round of 40.
And this is decent stuff. Very decent indeed. No after effects of picking up that dart off the floor.
One run and 34.
Single nine for double 16 for Mervyn King to break straight back in potentially 11 darts.
Game shot in the eighth leg.
What a game of darts we have here. Mervyn King breaks back, has the throw in two of the three remaining legs. And when it looked like Michael Smith had done enough to take control of this game, Merv fires straight back at him.
Yes, it's great to watch. Rat-a-tat-tat from both these guys. That treble 20 dead being pummeled by both players.
Six maximums on his own, Michael Smith.
140.
Get to the nitty gritty of this one.
137.
Yeah, it's best of three now, effectively, from here.
140.
Wow. 12 data from Smith, 11 data from Merv. Might be another 12 data coming in here. Needs the ball. And he misses it by a mile. Could be an 11 data here for Michael Smith. If he's low on the 20, he'll go top stops. He is low. And he is going top stops. And he hits it. 5-4 Michael Smith. Three legs of phenomenal quality from these two former champions on the European Tour.
That was class. And now throwing for the match.
60.
Superb pressure finish from Smith, but showing no signs of being under pressure at all the way he flung those in there with those two double tops.
Well, this is what we talk about. We talk about the best players. When they need it, when it's a tight game, when they really, really need it, they can find some extra gears to move through. They can pull out some incredible shots. And look at this. Two guys, as it gets to the nitty-gritty, have both raised their game. 12 dart break, 11 dart break, 12 dart break. The pendulum swinging back and forth. But who can get over the line? Right now, Michael Smith in the box seat. And a seventh 180 could be pivotal. Well, he could actually equal his record. We could break his record and get 10 180s in a Euro Tour. He holds that record jointly with Darryl Gurney. And he's not going to fire in three 180s.
But down to a finish. And the crowd being served up a real treat here. And that's before their man, Max Hopp, arrives on the stage.
Can he find that 54? It's awkward. Not too awkward. Back to the centre of the hockey. Bullseye for the bully boy.
87.
And it's a shocker.
Having to require 145.
Well, Mervyn can't respond. So Smith will be back for 35 for the match. And a semi-final berth against 45. Ian White. What a tasty encounter that 35. Proves to be. Oh, well.
Mervyn, you require
have we spoken too soon?
100 needed. Treble 20 for double top. Double top. Double 10.
80. Oh.
He would have had the throw.
Was that the moment? Double five for Michael Smith. Oh, he can't do it.
6 match darts missed by Michael Smith. Mervyn King needs double 10. Oh, sneaks it in, last dart, we are going the distance. Mervyn King, who performed an act of escapology to beat Darryl Gurney in the last leg decider, has the advantage of throwing first in a last leg decider against Michael Smith. Smith had done all the hard work, put in some fantastic stuff, but misses seven. Six match darts, I beg your pardon. Can he fashion another chance? Oh, he might do!
What a way to kick off. Response from Mervyn in some style. This is an absolute treat we're being served up here.
Massive scores, missed doubles, makes for entertaining darts. And we still don't know who's going to emerge victorious from this one. I would say that when Michael Smith hit those 9-180s in a Euro Tour game, he managed to lose the match, unbelievably. He's hit eight here. It might be nine. Oh, well, it's not going to be. But he has got himself down to a finish. Merv's looking at the 161.
Won't happen now. So, another chance for Michael Smith to seal the victory. One leg later than he would have liked to.
Needs a 57. Does not get it. 72 for Merv.
88. Mervyn, you require 72.
Just taking his time. Potentially two darts away from a place in the semi-final. Double top.
Oh, 52. Last shot of Michael's was 92.
92 scored, which means that Smith requires 24. He has missed six darts for the match. He survived one from Mervyn King, but he will not miss another one. A huge sigh of relief. An absolute Brahma in Saarbrücken as the King is deposed by Michael Smith. The Bully Boy, in search of a fifth Euro Tour title, has set up our first semi-final here at the German Darts Open. It is the Diamond Ian White versus Michael Smith, the Bully Boy. And let's hope he doesn't suffer too much of a kicking from Mervyn King there. The two practice partners will duke it out in the semi-finals for a spot in the final and a chance of glory on the European Tour. We're going to look at the other half of the draw now. Rob Cross, the world champion, against the Welsh number one Gerwyn Price. But first, Joe Cullen, so often a threat on the European Tour, so often denied in these final sessions, never made it to a Euro Tour final before. But Max Hopp, Germany's number one, will look to delight this 3,000-strong crowd in Saarbrücken and continue this incredible resurgence. The Maximizer versus the Rockstar after a few words from the Bully Boy.
Gereicht. Einen Matchstart hatte auf der Doppel 20. Michael, what happened?
Doubles. I had my chances early on, and then I gave Mervy's chances later on. And I thought I blew him, kicked off with the 180 last leg before, right, come on. And he... Not well. I've been ill for about a week now. No, I give Mervy's chance, he followed the way the 180, and I thought, just dig deep, please. Don't throw it away, and managed to get the job done.
The scoring was brilliant. I mean, I think 8-180s on such a distance, that's great.
Yeah, it was good, but the doubles, not so good. So